Well, the loss of taste and smell associated with COVID-19 isn't yet fully understood, but for a small number of patients, it never comes back. And for others, it's just not quite the same once it does. So what do doctors know so far, and is there a way to treat your loss of smell and taste because of COVID-19? Joining us with more is ear, nose, and throat specialist, Dr. Jay Piccirillo. Welcome to your morning.
Good morning. Glad to be here.
I'm glad to have you to answer these questions. There seems yet to be no consensus on why COVID-19 leads to this loss of taste and smell, but it affects up to 80% of people infected with the virus. So what are the theories going so far?
So it's truly one of the amazing parts about COVID-19 is the number of people who are suffering the problems with sense of smell that you just described. And as your slide showed, estimates are up to 80% of people upon acute infection with COVID will describe either loss, complete loss, or decreased sense of smell, decreased sense of taste as part or one of their presenting symptoms. It's truly unique for the rhinoviruses or the cold type viruses, the coronaviruses.
And we see it all over the world. I have a friend in another country, and this was one of their symptoms as well. Most people seem to recover that sense of smell and taste probably within a couple of weeks, but for about 5 to 10% of people, they either never get it back or it comes back in a compromised way. Do we know why that happens?
Well, that's exactly correct, and we don't know why. We think that the initial loss of smell is due to the virus infecting the cells that help the olfactory nerves, the nerves in our nose that help us smell. Those supporting cells get infected, they swell, they get injured by the virus, but they recover. And when they recover, they can do their job to help the olfactory nerve do its job. But for some people, perhaps the initial insult was too much and the olfactory nerve doesn't return, or as you mentioned, when the nerve comes back, the smell is distorted. And so we don't really have a good idea why that is, except it's probably related to the initial injury.
You say injury, and that leads me to my next question. So when I had a concussion once, I lost my sense of taste and smell for about a month. It came back. This phenomenon with COVID-19, how do you treat patients who describe their changes to their taste and smell after COVID-19? What do you do for them?
Yeah, so initially, steroids, both oral steroids and steroid nose sprays should be or can be attempted. And then there's something called olfactory training. So olfactory training is, as the name implies, training your nose to smell. And traditionally, patients will be instructed to smell maybe 4 different types of oils, rose, eucalyptus, lemon, cloves, twice a day for anywhere up to 12 weeks. And the idea behind olfactory training is that you are training or retraining your brain to recognize the smells. It's a process called neuroplasticity, training the brain to relearn its smell. And so that's primarily the treatment for these people with anosmia, no smell, and hyposmia, or the parosmia, it's a distorted smell.
You have a clinical trial underway that's talking about a new approach. Can you tell us about that?
Sure. Well, actually, we had 2 clinical trials, and unfortunately, we had no problems recruiting Americans through the internet for these 2 trials. And the one that I think you're referring to is the olfactory training, where we're asking 2 questions. Does the ability of the patient to pick their own unique smells, that is, the things that they want to get better, is that more effective than assigning them eucalyptus, rose, cloves, and chives? Excuse me, cloves. And then the other thing that we're testing is, does looking at a picture of the item while you're doing the training improve the ability of the olfactory training to retrain the brain? Yeah, so looking at a picture while you're smelling. Then we have another trial looking at the drug theophylline. Theophylline has been used for asthma for many years. And there's a variety of reasons that, won't go into on this show, but a variety of reasons that we think that theophylline may help the olfactory nerve recover. And so these patients are putting theophylline into a nose rinse, and then they rinse their nose with that daily for 6 weeks.
Dr. Piccirillo, last question before we go. As somebody in medicine and in science, what fascinates you about this loss of taste and smell associated with COVID-19?
Well, I think it's just the magnitude. The number of people at acute presentation that have lost their sense of smell. And then, again, like you alluded to, why is it that people continue to have loss of smell, the chronic changes? It's a real public health problem. So these are the things that fascinate me, but more importantly, motivate me to try to find a treatment.
Fascinating talking to you this morning, Dr. Piccirillo. Thanks for joining us.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this, be sure to subscribe here, or you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.